he blamed it on God. He was like, yeah, so the Lord has been really dealing with me about just stepping out and, you know, going for what I know. And he was like, so, and I was led to just kind of come up to you and, you know, he just told me to go ahead and do it. So I want to know if you, you know, were seeing anyone.
She was initially surprised. I guess you could say she was a little surprised. But she said, you know, I respect you for approaching me, but currently I'm in a relationship right now, and I don't think it's fair to talk or, you know, engage in any type of conversation while I'm in a relationship.
And I was like, but don't feel funny about seeing me at church. You can still say hi.
Yeah.
Can't you hear the bells on the Ralph, this is cousin Marlon. This is my wife, Rolanda Fagan.
Hi, Ralph Fagan.
Introduce myself to the family, rest of the family. I know Ralph probably introduced you. I remember Ralph when he was a little baby. Fagan, you got a real good one.
Amen.
You got a good one. I'm telling you. You know how the Lord talk about the scripture, where the wheat and the tares, you got a wheat. You ain't got a tare. You got a good one.
I ended up getting married. And then the marriage went down under, and we got divorced. Years passed, marriage, divorce, and then after the divorce, I remember thinking about him. And then it was so bad that I was thinking about him so much that I told my girlfriend, I was like, I feel like something's going on. Either this is the devil or this is God, because it's so heavy and it's like spiritual. So I know it wasn't like flesh, it wasn't like my thoughts. It was more just like, it just kept being downloaded in me. Like just, he would just like be, I don't know, just in my spirit. It was just like all up and through. And I was just kind of like, ah, I just want this to stop. I ended up having a dream about him. And in the dream, I was standing with a little baby boy, maybe a few months old. And the little baby boy was in my arms, and Ralph walked up to the baby boy and kissed the baby boy on the forehead and then kissed me, and then the dream was over.
So go ahead, release and feel peace, you know what I'm saying? Release and feel peace tonight at that hotel, brother. I know what you're gonna do. I know what you're gonna do, bro.
Being an impact, being a standard of what it is to wait on the person that you're supposed to be with. And so we just say thank you so much for just inviting us. We love y'all. We look forward to all the future babies, all the future, just all the love, and just sharing our testimonies. And we just said thank you so much, and we just really appreciate you guys, and we hope you guys have a blessed marriage.
Fast forward a few weeks later, I started thinking about him so much that I started praying for him, because I thought that that's why I was thinking about him. I was like, okay, Lord, maybe you're telling me to just pray for him. And so I started praying for him, and I did kind of like the high school thing. I was like, okay, I need a reason to talk to him, and I don't really have one right now, so I have to think of something. And so I ended up lying and telling him that I needed his help baking a cake for my daughter's birthday.
When she made the request, in my mind, I'm on Pinterest. I'm thinking about if I can do, you know, my pumpkin gooey cakes that I've done before, or I literally went on Pinterest and found a cake recipe and tested it just because she had asked me this question. But the biggest reason why it took me a few days to respond was, I did not know that when she did make that call that she was divorced.
I remember just seeing you around and being really super duper awkward. I mean, I've never, ever had that problem before. Not like I'm like a ladies' man or a man's lady. Up saying basically like, well, you know what, you know, he was like, well, maybe it is that you had to pray for me or whatever. And I was like, yeah. And then I said, but the thing is that after I prayed for you, it didn't go away, like it got stronger. And I said, it was weird. And so he was like, I don't know. So then I ended up having to get off the phone because I had my kids in the back and they were needing me. And I was like, you know what? I gotta go. I said, but can you call me back? I said, can you call me like in like an hour? And at the time, it was like 9 o'clock at night. And so he was like, he said, I'll call you tomorrow. He was like, I don't want to be disrespectful to your husband. And I was like, husband? And I've been divorced for months by then. So I was like, I'm not married. And he was like, you're not? He was like, yes, you are. He was like, wait, you're not? I was like, no. And he was like, oh.
The
his tone changed.
The awkwardness left the room.
It was completely different. Rico Suave came in the room. He was like, oh, okay, well, I'll call you back. And you know.
You believe that if you want to.
He went from like super brother in Christ to like, I'm gonna call you back. You know, got you. And so. He goes, well, maybe we're just supposed to be helping each other with our purpose. And he was like, maybe that's it. Maybe these dreams are just God telling us we're supposed to help each other with our purpose. And I was like, okay. And then the Lord literally said, right then and there, he said, ask him what his purpose is. Holy Spirit literally like dropped that in me. And I was like, oh my gosh. And I already knew. Because God was not going to tell me to say that without, he already knew what his verbiage was. Like, he's not, I don't know, like, I already knew what the answer was before he said it, because the Lord told me to ask him. And I started trembling almost in fear. Like, my hands are shaking and everything. I was like, I don't want to ask him for anything to say. And I'm going to freak out because I don't even know what that means. Like, what does that mean? Like, it was just a lot. And so I asked him, and I was just like, so what do you think your purpose is? Or do you know your purpose? And he was like, yeah, I'm supposed to be a pastor. And I literally, he doesn't even know this, I threw my phone.
Okay, congratulations, Fagan and Rob. We're so excited on this day that y'all have so much more to look forward to.
It was a really long moment of silence. And he said, well, I'm gonna go ahead and go pray, and I think you should too. I was like, two things happened at that moment. I was like, that's what I first thought. Like, really, dude? Like, that's what the answer is to this? But then the second thought, which was a much, you know, a stronger thought. It was like, wow, that's pretty amazing. I've never been with a guy who would have gotten off the phone at that point. And not only going right into prayer, but directed me into prayer. Like, he was just like, I'm about to go into prayer, and I think you should too. And I was just like, okay. And then it took him months and months and months to figure out I was his wife. Super slow.
Super slow.